metal bone. These are two in number. It has an external surface and an internal surface. It has four borders: the superior border, the anterior border, the posterior border, and the inferior border. These are also called the sagittal border, frontal border, occipital border, and the squamosal border. It has four angles: the anterior superior, the anterior inferior, the posterior superior, and the posterior inferior. Now, coming on the external surface. Now, on the posterior part of the sagittal border, we have a parietal foramen from where occipital artery passes. We have the parietal eminence. We've got two temporal lines: superior temporal line, which gives attachment to the temporal fascia, and the inferior temporal line, which gives attachment to the temporalis muscle. Now, coming to the internal surface. Internal surface, we have got grooves for cerebral sulci and carae, grooves for middle meningeal vessels. We got irregular pits called granulofovilli, which lodges the arachnoid pits. Now, coming on to the borders. This border forms the part of the coronal suture, this forms the sagittal suture, and this part forms the lambda suture. We have the bregma here, and we have the posterior fontanelle, also called lambda. Now, coming on the angles. The superior, anterior superior angle forms the bregma. The posterior superior angle forms the lambda. The anterior inferior angles form the pterion, which is the point of junction between four bones. The four bones being the temporal, parietal, frontal, and the greater wing of sphenoid. The posterior inferior border forms the asterion, which is the point of junction between three bones: the parietal bone, the squamous part of the temporal bone, and the occipital bone. To identify whether it's the parietal bone of the left side or the right side. The first point is that the anterior inferior angle is acute. We have a groove for sigmoid sinus on the posterior inferior border. And the one more point we can use for identification is that the middle meningeal vessels will be kind of projecting towards you, like we'll be projecting posteriorly. So this is the parietal bone of the left side.